Hello, Geminis. I want to thank you all so much for all of your love and support. You guys are incredible. The number of views, the number of likes, the subscribes. Honestly, I couldn't do it without you. And I got to talk to some of you after that last video, and you have such beautiful souls. You really do. So just a huge shout out to you guys. Thank you, Geminis. So where we left off last time, whoever I was connecting with, you had somebody who was just, I mean, they would do anything for you. So whether this will be tagging onto that reading or whether this will connect with somebody else, I'm not really sure yet. So please know that they're general messages. They will not resonate for everybody. So just take what does and leave the rest. If none of it resonates, that's okay. It's just not your reading this time. But also, please note too that we all have free will, so do not listen, or how do I put this? Don't give your power away to anybody, not to any tarot readers, not to anyone. You know, energy can change in a second, and a situation can change in a second due to free will, okay? So even if something comes out and you don't really like where it's headed, that's okay. You have the power to change it. The person you're dealing with has the power to change it. And nothing is ever set in stone, okay? This could have been something that happened in the past, so it is affirming it. This could be something that is happening now, or this could be something that is going to happen in the future. So please keep an open mind regarding these readings. So for Gemini, your cards are starting to come out. Playfulness, of course. That gorgeous, fun energy. My first love was a Gemini, actually. Never got over him. Go figure. So, we have forgiving and learning. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. You have religious factors. Your love life is being influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. And then you have playfulness. To recapture romance, allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. So, there's a few things already that I'm seeing here. It's possible that you or the person that you're dealing with or someone around you may have really been taking a look at how they were raised or their belief systems. And maybe they found themselves being a little bit stubborn and unyielding because they held on so tightly to what they believed. And I think that what's good about this is that there's some change that's taking place. It's like they've taken a look at what it has been that has crowned them and, you know, made them act or say the things that they did, because they're starting to realize that maybe some of the things that they've learned along their path wasn't exactly the right way or wasn't exactly what works in this connection. And now what I love is that if there was an argument or a tiff or some kind of misunderstanding, that the romance is going to be recaptured. And I see this playful energy, and I think that's coming from you, Geminis, because I know that you're a lot of fun. And I think that this is all going to sort itself out. It could have just been something minor. So let's see, what is the situation for Gemini, please, Spirit? Situation for Gemini, what's been going on here? Didn't I say about belief systems or society for that matter? It's possible that, how do I put this? How do I give a good example? Okay, here's a good example. Depending on our parenting structure or depending on our friends or the company we keep or in school, we may have learned along the way that relationships never work out. They never last, right? Well, I feel like this person is being challenged in their belief systems at this point in time, because they're seeing something different which contradicts what they were taught. So what they held as a belief, oh, relationships are never going to work out, maybe that made them run for a little bit, right? Because we have the runner and the chaser. Maybe that made them withdraw for a little bit because they got scared of their emotions and their feelings, right? And then they had to reassess, like, maybe relationships do work out, you know? Maybe they had to come to that point where it's like, it is going to work out for me. See? Didn't I say that? Wow, okay, Two of Cups in reverse. This is somebody who doesn't, I feel, believe, because this is about belief systems, believe in relationships going well for them. They're afraid of it. They think that, you know what, something is going to go wrong. Maybe it's because of a past situation, but I feel like their belief systems are being challenged and changed, and you are being a huge catalyst for this. You are really helping them see, look, you know, you don't have to take life so seriously. You don't have to take beliefs so seriously. Everything's flexible. How they see you, I think that they realize that they may have hurt you because they weren't, because they weren't giving all of themselves. So this Three of Swords as well is about their negative thinking, right? Because what happens is in the Two of Swords that comes before the Three of Swords, they put a blindfold on. And usually that blindfold, and I feel like in this connection, was to protect them. It's like they wanted to stay stuck in everything that they knew. So maybe someone around them was saying, you know, keep an open mind or keep your eyes open because honestly, relationships don't work. It's going to end anyway, blah, blah, blah. Maybe they had some negative people around them, which is these extra swords. And that, you know, that was driving the wedge through their heart. So when their heart is hurting because of belief systems that don't really serve them, they can't open up properly, hence this Ace of Cups in reverse. So that's what I'm getting here, is just that this person was heavily influenced by some situation or some relationship in the past that formed a belief that, oh, I'll never be happy. I will never be able to find the one. Which, of course, is untrue. Yeah, see, I was going to say, because how they see this connection, the sun. This is completely contradicting what they've believed for so long. And they're just, they're not understanding. And it's funny how it comes up beside playfulness, because then they meet you, right? They meet you and they're having fun. They're happy. They're enjoying their time with you. They don't understand. Why is this not falling apart? They don't understand why they feel so good around you. They don't understand why they feel reborn and so much happiness. It's completely, I think, doing their brain in. They're just like, what do you mean? I mean, relationships don't work out. I've seen it with my friends. I've seen it with my family and my Uncle Joe, whoever be the case. It just doesn't work. Why is this working? There's something here. It's like they're waiting for something to fall apart. They're just freaked out. See, because they need to get themselves unstuck, and that is what's happening. You beautiful Geminis, you are bringing them a new perspective. Do you see this Hanged Man in reverse? That's beautiful. If it was upright, it would be that they would have to be looking at the situation again, that they would literally be holding back. But now they're getting unstuck because you've brought... You guys keep touching my heart with your readings lately. You guys have brought sunshine and happiness into their life. And you can even see it around this person's head. It's like, there's that sun, right? The sun is around their head. And you have just completely lit up their belief systems. And you've changed how they've been operating for so long. I just had a deja vu. Oh my gosh, I feel like I've been here before. So here we go. What they want and what they need. They've got to let down their defenses. Do you see the wounded warrior, right? He's got this bandage around his head and he's looking back to the past. This is exactly what it is. This person is looking to the past and they're saying, you know, I've just seen so many relationships fall apart. This can't be right. This can't be right. And yet they still continue to keep going. And the reason why is because there's something inside of them. There's something inside of them that is changing, and it's because of you. And maybe you've been patient with them, and maybe your playfulness and not being so serious all the time is helping them chill out. Do you know what I'm saying? Here we go. Three of Cups in reverse. Exactly. Situations around them never worked out in the past, right? Maybe they were cheated on previously. Maybe they were lied to and they were deceived, and they thought, you know what? Yeah. So what I feel like is they want to release this defensiveness, which would make sense then as to why this forgiving and learning is happening. Maybe also with your beautiful energy that you're bringing to them, they are now able to let go of the resentment from the past. And I'm getting, I'm hearing now I understand why it didn't work out. Now I understand why it didn't work out with that other person is because Gemini is here. And this is so much more happier. It's like they're starting to release whatever it was that they were holding on to. And again, this could be people, naysayers around them, right? So if they've had negative people around them who also have gone through breakups, these people are probably, or have been saying to them, like, look, you know, because this is about society. It's not going to work out. You've seen our relationship and it didn't work out. So I feel like this person is just, you know, really coming out of old belief systems, and you've helped them challenge and grow. So what it is that I see in terms of what the obstacle is, working on that inner conflict, there it is. And I feel like, again, it's just the naysayers around them or life itself. You know, if you turn on the news, you don't really see a lot of positivity on the news. You don't really see a lot of good stories online, because that's where a lot of people go to vent. So I think that this person needs to stay focused on what they have in front of them. And there's this Gemini, which is you. And I think that that's what they're going to be doing. They're going to keep their head down and not allow all of these opposing views and opposing words, if you will. Sorry, there goes my throat chakra. To deter them from the happiness, because they know what you're worth. So I think if they may have pulled away or acted a little weird recently, I think it's just because their beliefs have been challenged and you are showing them a whole new way of existing, and you're bringing fun and happiness into their life. Oh, that's beautiful. And look at this. So this is coming into the outcome position, Queen of Pentacles. You're loving, you're nurturing, well, what's interesting too is the paradox of this. Is this playful energy that you bring to them is bringing them security. It's funny how not being so serious brings security. It's like, you know what, I can just enjoy this moment. See what I mean about focusing on that pentacle? I think they're just going to focus on you now. And you're bringing them, like I said, the abundance. Because the Queen of Pentacles is somebody who has many luxuries around them and a lot of comfort. And they are feeling comfortable, right? You are starting to show them that it's okay. I love this. I just love this. What is the Queen of Pentacles also, please, Spirit? Exactly. They're turning their back to these beliefs of being rejected, being left out in the cold, suffering, being on their own, being hurt. They are finally enjoying the moment. And as they spend their time in this moment of playfulness with you, I don't even know if you know this, Gemini, but you're healing somebody. You are healing somebody on a soul level. You have been a light in somebody's life. And maybe you didn't even realize. Maybe that's why Spirit is showing me this reading for you. Is maybe you didn't even realize how much you're bringing to somebody's growth on this planet. Like, you know how sometimes we ask ourselves, what is the meaning of life? Why are we here? Did you know that possibly it's just your beautiful self and your beautiful fun energy that you are bringing security and safety to somebody who never had it? Do you know that you might be bringing somebody the love that they never felt before in their life? Maybe they didn't have a good upbringing. Maybe they didn't have good relationships with their family. Maybe they were the scapegoat of the family. Do you know what I mean? It's like, I'm actually starting to feel a bit emotional here, because I feel that this is so beautiful. It's like every time that they felt rejected or hurt by somebody, you are the one who's literally putting them in your lap and saying, everything's okay. Look at the gentle smile. Everything's okay. Let's just go out in the sunshine here. Let's just go have fun. Let's just go laugh. Let's just go do something. You know, you're not letting them stay stuck in this Three of Swords energy. Oh, that is just so, so incredibly beautiful. So I feel like this connection is going to continue to grow. And I feel like as they start to realize that they can just chill, everything's okay, that they're going to find this security and they're going to be able to bring abundance to you, because they're no longer going to be focused on what they're going to lose. And of course, they don't want to lose you, which is, I think, the biggest fear that's driving this. so they're going to be able to feel secure enough. Yes, surrender to what is. Flow with what is instead of fighting it. When you can't change a situation, compassionately accepting it exactly as it is will bring you peace. I think that this is what this person is doing now. Like I said back here about this belief system, it is now they're starting to understand, like, it's okay, I don't have to fight this. I don't have to be on defense all of the time. I don't have to, you know, make my partner prove to me that they care. Instead, they're starting to flow with what is. Just as I was saying, you're bringing them this warmth, this healing, this happiness. And what a shift in this person's life. The impact that you've had. That's probably why I never got over my first love. And surrender to creativity. I told you, they're going to start being able now to contribute to this connection instead of showing up hesitant. Let your imagination soar. Stay open to all of the creative ideas about how to pursue a dream or solve a problem. I feel that this is just you showing them, especially the way that she's holding a mirror. It's like you're just showing them the way that they've seen things and then being in your present, just how different they are, especially with that butterfly there. It's like you're freeing them. You're freeing them from whatever prison, and I feel like it was a mental prison that they had themselves in or that they were headed towards. So Geminis, you have seriously impacted somebody on a soul level, and you were part of their path. This is huge. You were part of their path. They were meant to meet you, and no matter what, the impact that is had here is just beautiful, and I see that this connection is going to continue to evolve and become more comfortable as the days go on. Let's see. And especially once they get out of their own way, then they're able to give more, right? So don't be surprised if you find yourself being pampered, being loved on, because now that this person is getting out of the way of their fears, you're their focus, right? So let's see. What is this? I told you! Two of Cups. They're going to show up. They are going to mirror to you all of the happiness. And I say happiness because I'm looking at all of the yellow in this card. They're going to bring to you everything that you give them. Wow. This... I'm actually speechless. That's so beautiful. I feel like this is a soulmate connection. You might just be their guardian angel on the earth plane. You just might be their catalyst for growth in this lifetime. How does it feel to have that impact on somebody? Wow. All right, Geminis, sending you so, so much love. Obviously, Spirit is saying keep being you, and can't wait to see you again soon. Have a great one. Bye, guys.